can't find a good reason, can't find hope to believe in.
So let's take a look at Still Waiting. I have not seen what's in Still Waiting in a long time, but there's not much. Most of the songs on Does Look Infected, there was really not much going on. It was basically just the band. I don't think we added any keyboards really back then. Let's just take from the top here.
So,
ooh, there's a lot of compression on that.
So am I still waiting for this world to stop hating? Can't find a good reason, can't find hope to believe in.
The riff is basically just an octave thing.
Just a
single vocal. I doubled, basically just doubled myself with those kinds of things. And then on its own track coming up here, I did this. Going into the chorus there. So let's take a look at this chorus here. I mean, there's basically just, oh yeah, has its own two tracks for just the pick slide. Anyway, it looks like I sang the chorus three times.
So am I still waiting for this?
So that's myself tripled.
Can't find it.
And under that is, of course,
so am I
my harmony.
Waiting for this world to stop hating.
And then the odds.
So am I down. So am I down.
I remember like coming up with that in the studio thinking, you know, I wanted to have some sort of lyric under there, and for some reason never came up with a real lyric other than, I just remember thinking, even though So Am I Down was not really special, but when you hear it in context of the whole thing, it seemed to just work for some reason against the rest of the words, because if there was anything else, it felt like it was getting too wordy and it was jumbling up the lead melody. So Am I Down just seemed to work.
So am I still waiting for this world to stop raining? Can't find a good reason, can't find hope to believe in.
Guitars. So that would be, it was always usually me on the left, Dave on the right, with Les Paul 59, and then he would play Paul Reed Smith. There's a guitar in the middle here, which is usually like an SG played by either one of us. So let's hear this chorus here with all vox in, and of course the good old pick slide. Just goes to single vocal here. So here in this chorus, I mean, there's what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 things that make up this chorus. That's a lot of vocals. And it's a lot of my vocal too. So to make it all sort of sound different, I mean, like I was saying, like this So Am I Down lyric sort of fit, and you know, with the ahs, and I think I possibly sang into different microphones back then to make it sound a little different. Sometimes I'll sing a little differently, whereas if you solo it, it sounds kind of strange. I'll do that for my harmonies to just try to sound a little bit more strange than my lead vocal already is, I guess. You know, and then of course the riff, my favorite part. Yeah, that's Dave playing the riff, obviously. And then my favorite part, pick slide.
So am I still waiting for this world to stop painting? Can't find
You know, and then at the very end here, the riff comes back in. Now there's a lot of stuff going on. And that's a short song. I don't even know how long it is. Probably just over 2 minutes or something. The funny thing about Still Waiting, it was the very last song that I wrote for the record. And we were in New York City. It was like we were just about to leave for New York. And I'd come up with a little part of it, but not much of it. So when by the time we were in studio in New York, I remember sitting in the hotel and really trying to finish this because we all felt from just a little bit that I had written in Toronto before we got to New York, we knew there was something good about this song. We really wanted to get it done. So I just, right when we got to New York, I sat in a hotel room for only about 2 days maybe and just really tried to finish this song. And obviously it was great that we finished it because it became the first single for the record, which we were surprised that it became the first single because we really loved the song. We knew as a band that we wanted this to be the first single, but it was so different than Fat Lip and In Too Deep, which had come right before it, that we weren't sure that the label was going to go for it. And at the time, I remember when we were almost finished tracking everything and a few people from the label came down and we were really nervous about what they were going to say. And we didn't mention that we thought this was going to be the first single or we wanted it to be. We just played it and said, what do you think? And back in those days, Island Def Jam was amazing. They're the people, the team that we had there, everybody was great. We were all on the same page. And we didn't even say to them, they said it to us, this is the first single. And it was just within, you know, a month or a couple months later, it was out on the radio. I mean, this record was done really, really quick. It wasn't much thought. It was just kind of put it out and go. And it worked.